took the team a little bit, a little while to get into gear. How much of it was the heat? How much of it was jet lag? How much of it?
I was good. Came out and played, you know, 10-hour flight, so you want to come out here and play as hard as you can. You want to get your money's worth, so that's what I tried to, you know, instill in the team.
Well, when you came out, you were ready, but you started the game on the bench, and those guys didn't execute right away. What do you think that was?
I mean, you know, they probably were just probably a jet lag, you know, just getting, you know, new roles, you know, a lot of those. We started a lot of veterans today, so they really never started before, so it was a first time for them, but they got it going.
A couple explosive finishes at the rim. Do you feel stronger, more explosive when you're going over there?
Yeah, I mean, I told you, I've been working hard in the weight room. Two a days with Fletch, working hard with Fletch, and, you know, it's showing. So I'm going to keep working. Keep working on my overall game and, you know, trying to come out here and play as hard as I can play, no matter who we play against.
Is it something you can sense physically, like when you're about to go up? Is it something that you know that you have now, maybe that you didn't?
Yeah, one of those, I want him to jump with me, but he ain't jump. It's just, you know, I feel a little stronger. You know, my legs feel stronger. I feel good out here. I love hot gym. I went to Morgan Park, so our gym is real little, and I love this environment. So, you know, this get me going, get my blood flowing.
It's kind of funny to look back and coming out of high school when one year Knox was making the outside shots.
Yeah.
What's been the key there?
Been working. I mean, that's all it is work. Getting up early in the morning, getting 300, 400 shots before we start practice. That's all it is. Practice makes perfect. So the more work you put in, the more the better you can be.
You got a lot of family here. Did you have any time to hang out with them before?
No, not yet. They were here before I got here. So I'm going to spend some time with them either today or tomorrow. Because they was in, Florence. They were, where are we going next? They were there already. So I'm going to spend some time with them.
When you guys walk into a gym like this, half the world away, are you surprised to see, like, you know, people you've seen around before he's us? And
no, like, I mean, this is what it is. This is what a lot of that is about. You know, we support each other and we love each other. That's one thing about our fans. They support and they love us. So it was great to see so many people here supporting us. That also got us going.
Allen's really making it one of his signatures to make an impact on the offensive glass. Just what have you seen from him there in practice and this game, and what is he providing?
I mean, that's one of my best friends on the team. So, you know, I try to tell him to bring the energy as much as you can. We don't need people to go to the glass each and every time. And he just picked that up and ran with it, so I'm happy for him.
How much of a difference did it make to not have Kofi and Andres here in terms of the plan, the game plan, and what you wanted to try to do?
Oh, I mean, they are a crucial part of this team, so, you know, we always need them, want them. They take care of some other business, so we just wanted to come out and play as a unit, you know. Each next man up, so the next guy has to step up, but we know we're going to need both of those guys if we want to accomplish our goals.
From your floor general perspective, what would you like to see developed from tonight into tomorrow night, execution-wise?
Get a little more crisp with my pocket passes. I feel like I let the ball bounce a little bit too high, but those are little minor things that I could just tweak up, watch a little film, and I'll be all right.
Coach Underwood said you want to take a back seat from the chair over there. Do you think, like, he accomplished his goal, or was he stepping?
Yeah. He's good. He'll get us no matter what. We probably have the team meet. He'll yell at us because in the first half we played poor defensively. But he just being a head coach who want to win, so you can't blame him for, you know, how intense he is. Because at the end of the day, you know, he wants to win.
Thanks, man.
What's that?